My name is Peter, and welcome again aboard the sailing vessel Silverheels. Last winter, when I was researching all topics nautical and dreaming of having a Rhodes 22, one of the subjects that I looked into was marine sanitation. There's a couple of choices when you get into that topic. And initially I thought the way I wanted to go was a marine head, because that's what I had experience with in the boat my family owned when I was a teenager. But of course in those days, marine heads did not have holding tanks. But the more I started to read about it, the less sure I was that that was the way I wanted to go. And then I stumbled on the topic of marine composting toilets. I first found two models, brands that are very similar, Nature's Head and Airhead. One was certainly copied from the other, I'm sure. And people seem pretty pleased with them on the most part, especially if you're not using them, you know, full-time live aboard. But the big issue with those two units is that they're both about 21 inches tall, as I recall. And the area for the head that on the Rhodes 22 doesn't have an overabundance of vertical space. Back in the archives, someone reported that they did actually get one installed on a Rhodes 22. Actually, Stan did the installation. So last November, when my wife and I went down and had a conversation with Stan, I brought up this subject, and he pretty firmly discouraged me from going that route. They're just, not only are the units pretty expensive, but the installation would be expensive. So I don't know exactly what Stan had to do to get one of those units into a Rhodes 22, but apparently it was a lot of work. So I kind of gave up on that and assumed I'd be going with a porta potty type toilet. But then I eventually came across a third option in the composting toilet. The brand is called Seahead, and it's a significantly different design in a couple of ways. And the fellow who makes them offers several versions, and one of which just recently he came out with is the Shorty, which is only 15 inches high. So that offered at least the possibility that it would fit into the Rhodes 22, and I did some messing around, and I found that yes, indeed, it will work. So I have ordered one, and I'll take you through the process of installing it, and we'll go into the cabin, and I'll outline our general approach on this. So if you look here at the junction between the cabin floor and the head floor, you can see that the head floor is about 3 inches higher than the cabin floor. And I've already torn the boat apart once to prove to myself that this is going to work, and then I put it back together. But what I found when I tore it down is that there seems to be no good reason for that. My guess is that it's necessary when you have a marine head, but it doesn't seem to be necessary for any reason if you don't have a marine head, and that's just a guess on my part. So our approach is we're gonna lower the head floor to make it flush with the cabin floor. And that'll give us the room we need for the 15-inch high composting toilet. So, how do we go about doing that? So in order to get the floor out so we can lower it, we need to get this piece to the left out because the floor runs underneath it. And in order to get that out, we need to remove the entire settee top. We'll also need to remove the compression post, and that means we'll be taking the mast down before we do that step. But It's a little bit easier to get the big piece, the settee, out with the pop top up. So we'll leave the mast up for now and start taking stuff apart. So the first thing we're going to do is take the cushions and put them someplace where someplace safe in the house. So the cushions are gone, but actually before we can remove the main settee piece, we need to remove this piece along the aft wall of the cabin. Not quite sure what its function is, and it's one of a couple of pieces that for some reason Stan's crew neglected to stain. You know, it's obviously some new plywood there. So as part of this project, I guess we'll take the opportunity to apply some stain when we have these pieces out. So then the forward end of the settee can be lifted and slid forward up onto the V-berth so that the rear end will clear this lip here, and then the whole thing can be brought out of the cabin. So here's what we have with the settee removed. The drawer is still here, and we'll need to take that out. And I'm struck by this area over the centerboard under the step, that there's a fair amount of room there that's not being used for anything. We'll have to give that some thought. I don't believe it's strictly necessary for this project, but I want to take the carpet out next, which means that the table base needs to come out, and also this little piece of trim down here. The carpet's kind of jammed under it. So those two things will come out, and then the carpet will come out. So the last major piece that's standing in the way of us being able to remove the head flooring is the compression post. And before we take down the compression post, we need to take down the mast. And the first step in taking down the mast is to lower the pop top. So on we go. Okay, the mast is down, and the next step towards our goal of removing the compression post is to remove this wire chase, where the wires that go up to the mast are hidden. So, and that's just some more screws. Okay, so the next item is this little plate up at the ceiling. That's kind of holding the top of the compression post in place. So there's that. And down at the bottom, there's a couple more screws. And I think that's going to be it. There's a groove on the starboard side of the compression post that this panel goes into. A dado in woodworking terms. So the post needs to slide to port first to free it. There. All right, and now it'll come out, but I need two hands to do it. As I mentioned, I've done this before. I took it all apart, and then I put it back together. But I didn't put the screws back in that are holding the head floor down. So no need to take them out a second time. So I think we're all set. And yeah, this will come out. And there's what we have underneath. I'll take the floor piece away and come back to discuss this. So again, here's the space under the floor of the head. So as you can see, we've got a couple of fiberglass stringers here, and I'm going to guess these are not original, but were put in as part of the recycling process. And these are going to be part of the support system for the new floor. But we also want to support it on the sides. Now, one of the issues we're going to have is that the panel here behind the aft of the V-berth doesn't really go down as far as it we need it to. So we're going to have to build a trim piece there. And honestly, we haven't worked out every detail of this process, but we'll work it out and take you along for the ride. So almost a week has gone by. I have lots of other chores other than working on the boat, mostly in terms of gardening here in the spring of the year. But I finally got some time to get back to this, and it's turning out to be more straightforward than I had feared it might turn out to be. So I have made the piece that serves the effect of extending this partition down further into the bilge, which we needed to happen in order to support this piece, which is going to support the floor. So at the same level here as the stringer. We did have to notch out the stringer here to accommodate that. So that's a piece of oak. I have lots of oak and no teak. And naturally we'll stain that and put some nice decorative edge along the top here. So that takes care of the forward side of the compartment. Yeah. Here on the aft side, it was more straightforward. We just screwed some supports to the an existing piece of plywood. We did have to cut a notch here for wires, unfortunately, but I still think we're going to get plenty of support. This piece was a pain. It's a piece of, looks like pressure-treated plywood, 3/4 inch, and it's glassed in. And it was sticking up here. Originally I thought that I would trim the floor to go around it, but that would be kind of ugly. So I sawed it off flush, again, with the stringer. And that was a chore. There's probably a special tool that would have made that easy, but I didn't have it, whatever it might be, and so I just used my grandfather's handsaw, and it took a while, but it ended up being a nice, clean job. So that's where we are, and what we need to do now is make a floor. And here we have the floor installed. This is not the first time it's been in place, and it's not here permanently. There's still more work to be done, but I reused the original floor, trimmed it down a little, and repurposed it. The hardware that I've installed there is the hardware for holding the C-head in place. And, well, I guess I might as well show you that. So there it is, a C-head installed on a Rhodes 22. And here I am sitting on the C-head. There is headroom for me. I'm 5'7" and a half, but there's not a lot to spare. So keep that in mind if you are taller than average. Of course, with a hatch here, you can get some more headroom by opening that. There are a few more things I need to do that are critical, and I'll show you one right now. So you may recall that at the edge of this panel that divides the head from the galley goes the compression post, a very critical structural element. And in its the way it was before, the bottom of the compression post was supported by this piece of plywood and by the floor, which was the top of the floor was flush with this piece of plywood. So, and there's structural items that go all the way down into the to the keel that support that. So we've shortened one of those pieces. You may recall that piece I sawed off. So we need to have something in this area that will take the place of, you know, and once again provide the structure to take the load from the compression post down to the keel. So a lot of other stuff is trim work, but that's structural, and we'll need to address that. So here is a new base for our compression post. So I think the last piece that we need to create for this project will be a piece of trim for this area to cover up the seam here and hide that plywood. So another piece of oak. For that. So here's the test fit of our final pieces. We have the new compression post support here in place. Not screwed in. That'll get screwed in here before the compression post is put in, and so the screw for that will be hidden. And a new trim piece on the bottom here, and there's a dado in the back here, backside, for the wires to run through. And I put the pre-existing wire chase back in place just to be sure that everything would fit together. All right. Well, now we take it all apart again and do some final sanding and preparation and staining. Our trim pieces have been stained and everything has been reassembled. And let's see what it looks like with the toilet installed. So there you have it. We'll have to wait. I have one more project before I can reinstall the top of the piece on the settee. There might be a close clearance issue between the toilet and the fold-down forward settee seat. I think it's going to clear. And if not, well, it's only wood. And it's malleable. So the boat has been put back together completely, I think. No parts left over. Including the settee. Well, the cushions are still in the house for safety. And this fold-up seat clears the toilet seat by, oh, I don't know, 1/16 of an inch or so. That's pure serendipity, not planning. Though if it did not quite clear, you know, the toilet seat could be lifted to make a little more clearance room. And there's lots of room when it's all the way down. So that's the installation. It may have occurred to you that I have really avoided talking about kind of the larger issue of why a composting toilet and the pros and cons and hows and wheres and really there's two reasons for that. One, this video is long enough already, and two, you can already find lots of information about that if you care to search on the internet, if this subject interests you. I should also say that obviously what I've demonstrated here was installation on a Rhodes 22 with the semi-enclosed head. I don't really know, but I strongly suspect that it really wouldn't work with the fully enclosed head. There just wouldn't be enough room. But someone, if you have a fully enclosed head, you'd have to do the head scratching to figure that out on your own. One final word is on ventilation. The sea head can be ventilated, and in fact it comes with some fittings and some hose to facilitate that. But according to the information I got with the toilet and research I did ahead of the purchase, for occasional use, like a couple days a week, ventilation is almost certainly not required. So we're going to go without ventilation and see how it goes. Probably at the end of the season, after we have some experience using this, there'll be another video about our experiences, but that's it for now. Thanks for watching.